वेलकम टू दिस एपीसोड ऑफ द हरप्रीत सिंह शो। हर साल साइकिलिंग फॉर डायवर्सिटी वालों एक आयोजन किया जाता है साइकिलिंग टूर का, जिस विच के वक्रे वक्रे शहरों के डायवर्सिटी की जो इंपॉर्टेंस है उसके बारे गलबात की जाती है। इस साल भी 21 तारीख तो यानी कि 21 मई तो 25 मई तक साइकिलिंग का एक टूर किया जा रहा है, जिहदे विच के ये मैसेज दिता जाएगा कि डायवर्सिटी की की इंपॉर्टेंस है, क्यों सानू जुड़ना चाहिए है। इस संबंध में मेरे को स्टूडियो आए हुए हैं दो मेहमान साढ़े, कैन हरार जिहड़े कि साइकिलिंग फॉर डायवर्सिटी ये बाणी हैं, डेप्टी चीफ ऑफ एबट्सफोर्ड पुलिस रिक लूसी। आओ दोनों का स्वागत करते हैं, इन्हों नाल गलबात करते हैं कि यह जो प्रोग्राम करन जा रहे हैं इसकी की इंपॉर्टेंस है। वेलकम टू द प्रोग्राम।
थैंक यू
फॉर योर टाइम। सो वील स्टार्ट ऑफ विद यू, कैन यू स्टार्टेड विद दिस आइडिया ऑफ हैविंग अ साइकिलिंग टूर वेयर बाय विद अ मिशन विच वॉज टू स्प्रेड द मैसेज ऑफ डाइवर्सिटी। सो सिंस व्हेन हैव यू स्टार्टेड दिस एंड व्हाट हैव यू गेन ड्यूरिंग दीज ईयर्स?
वेल, वी स्टार्टेड मई 2011, वी रोड फ्रॉम मिशन टू विक्टोरिया। वेल, 2 इयर्स नाउ वी आर So doing it in our third year, mm-hmm. and this year we're cycling from Victoria to Abbotsford, visiting 14 towns,
okay.
and about 27 schools.
Mm-hmm. And during this tour, where you're going to be on the road for 4 days,
right.
what all is going to happen? Like you talk about the 14 cities, but what happens during when you go and talk to the people?
Right. So what we do is we visit schools, mm-hmm. talk to kids about diversity, culture, and inclusion.
Right.
Our main message is celebrate our diversity, but also be inclusive with each other.
Right.
Let's celebrate diversity in our neighborhoods. Mm-hmm. Let's celebrate diversity in our workplaces and on our sports fields.
Okay.
And be inclusive with each other. That's very important.
Right. Mr. Lucy, why do you think there's a need for spreading this kind of message?
Well, personally, I love to support anything that has a diversity theme to it. I just love that we live in a part of the world where we have such wonderful diversity. And so, personally, the idea that we can celebrate where we live and the people that live where we live.
Mm-hmm.
From a policing point of view, we're happy, the Abbotsford Police Department's happy to support this Cycling for Diversity, because we often get to see the bad side of when people aren't so tolerant of each other or do actually practice mm-hmm. things that are either from a hateful point of view or some other area of ignorance.
And right.
And so to be part of helping a community be safe and enjoyable and a place where people can be comfortable living, from a policing point of view, we're happy to participate because it means a great deal to us.
And you also yeah. participate yourself also.
I do. I do. I enjoy the cycling piece, which is, of course, as a foundation for this Cycling for Diversity,
mm-hmm.
Makes it extra interesting to be able to do that and as part of the backbone for the spreading the message. So,
right.
So it's fun that way, and
okay.
yes, love to participate.
That's great. And I would like to know some of your experiences, because you have been a part of this for the past 2 years. So when you go interact, and especially when we talk about, like Ken talked about, inclusiveness, how important this Cycling for Diversity team plays a role in spreading that message?
It's fascinating, because I was talking with someone this morning about it, because it's coming up so soon now, and the children at the schools, the idea that they get quite fascinated by the idea that there's this cycling event that would go from Victoria to Abbotsford and Mission area and all the towns in between.
Mm-hmm.
The idea that people are willing to go for a long ride and spread a message across the schools fascinates them, and so that they are interested then in being able to talk diversity, because they get quite intrigued by the idea that people are willing to bike around and do that. And
mm-hmm.
so it's kind of a neat part, and a lot of the questions, the opening questions from the kids, end up being about the cycling part of it.
Mm-hmm.
And then it allows you to get into a conversation about diversity, which they are
right.
really interested in doing once they hear about the biking part.
Right. Yeah. Ken, if yeah. I recall, the idea which prompted you to start this kind of initiative was that once you were barred from entering a particular place.
That's right.
So that is where this idea came, and now it is spreading quite fast.
Yes.
How important is this role, what you feel you are playing in spreading this message, and how is this message being taken by all?
People love the idea.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a columnist now for 18 years, and I was from Mission Times, and
mm-hmm.
I get regular feedback from the public. And they say, Ken, our communities are not connected. What can we do? So I thought of this idea.
Mm-hmm.
I was only going to do it once, but
right.
Serena Dirksen, the executive coordinator, said, you got to do it again.
Right.
So here we are today. So it's very important. and some of the lower man communities were not connected.
Mm-hmm.
So we encourage kids and adults to connect with each other. That's,
right.
that's very important. And I think we have to always create awareness.
Mm-hmm.
And that's very important as you move forward. You know, we're also very excited to introduce your son as part of the team, and you.
Mm-hmm.
We have a father and son, so we're very excited about that.
Well, thank you.
You know, so we got some great team members coming on this year.
Right.
Yeah.
So now, again, as you are saying that this was a single person initiative, but now the message is spreading and people are coming forward, and especially the children, they want to understand, they want to learn.
Right.
And if we recall last year when we went to the schools over there also, we saw that many places children didn't know about, though we are living in this lower mainland, which is the hub of diversity, but still they have been kept aloof from these kind of things.
Right.
So now, as this year you are focusing from Victoria towards Abbotsford,
yes.
what is going to be the focus when you go and talk in the schools? Rick, from you, I would like to know first,
sure.
from the police perspective, how important this particular cycling tour can be effective, and also from your personal perspective, what message can be given?
Yeah, so I like to talk. We explain who we are and, mm-hmm. and kind of where we come from as part of giving a little bit different perspective. And so I do share that I'm a police officer, and some of what I commented on earlier about the idea that we want people to be thinking about it, because mm-hmm. If it doesn't happen in a positive way, then there can be some really negative things that happen. And I try to make that a real statement without being too much of a negative message in
right.
terms of what we're trying to do, because we want this to be a positive experience, of
mm-hmm.
course, for the particularly the students at the schools. And the message that goes with that is this challenge for people, that the idea that knowledge is power, and so that people, if they will take away the idea that learning about diversity, learning about each other, learning about all of the things that we ought to celebrate
mm-hmm.
versus be unaware of and perhaps staying away from or scared of or critical of,
mm-hmm.
We ought to learn about, and we ought to then turn that into something we should enjoy. So,
right.
so it's a part, I kind of come at it from that direction.
And a lot of ifs and buts, they also get sidelined, because once the children interact, once the people interact with each other, they come to know the exact situation.
Yes,
exactly.
Yes. And how much is it being recognized at the provincial level or at the municipal level or at the federal level also?
Well, municipality, locally, we've got about 10 proclamations from local governments,
mm-hmm.
and the mayors come out, or council members welcome the team to their towns.
Right.
Also, the province has named it Cycling for Diversity Week here,
uh-huh.
with a proclamation from
right.
the May 19th to the 25th.
Okay.
And we also have Randy Camp, MP for Mission Maple Ridge Pitt Meadows, statement in the House of Commons.
Okay.
So
it's going further now. People are coming and joining in this bandwagon.
That's right. You know,
right.
everybody on the team has a little bit of a different message,
uh-huh.
but it's all together. It's a
right.
very collective message. So it becomes a very powerful message.
We'll continue with the discussion. Let's go for a small break. And then, Mr. Rick, how has your training been? Have you been cycling to now when you're going to start on the 21st? We'll talk about this after this break.
All right.
ਘਰ ਇੱਕ ਐਸੀ ਥਾਂ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਹਰ ਕੋਈ ਆਪਣੀ ਨਿੱਜੀ ਜ਼ਿੰਦਗੀ ਦੇ ਸੁਨਹਿਰੀ ਪਲ ਯਾਦ ਰੱਖਦਾ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਜਗ੍ਹਾ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਉਹ ਰਹਿੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਤੇ ਪਿਆਰ ਭਰਿਆ ਜੀਵਨ ਬਤੀਤ ਕਰਦਾ ਹੈ ਇਹ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਤਾਂ ਹੀ ਪੂਰੀਆਂ ਹੁੰਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ ਜਦ ਕਿਸੇ ਜਗ੍ਹਾ ਨੂੰ ਸਜੇ ਹੋਏ ਘਰ 'ਚ ਬਦਲਿਆ ਜਾਵੇ ਨਵੇਂ ਘਰਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਫਰੇਮਿੰਗ ਤੋਂ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਫਿਨਿਸ਼ਿੰਗ ਤੱਕ ਡਰੇਪਰੀ ਪੇਂਟਿੰਗਸ ਤੋਂ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਡੈਕੋਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਅਸੈਸਰੀਜ਼ ਤੱਕ ਤੁਸੀਂ SK ਹੋਮ ਡਿਜ਼ਾਈਨਸ ਦੀਆਂ ਪ੍ਰੋਫੈਸ਼ਨਲ ਸਰਵਿਸਿਜ਼ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਸੁਪਨਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਘਰ ਨੂੰ ਹਕੀਕਤ 'ਚ ਬਦਲ ਸਕਦੇ ਹੋ ਕੰਟੈਕਟ ਕਰੋ ਸੰਦੀਪ ਕੌਰ 604-825-9295
Once again, welcome back to the program. Break to pehla cycling for diversity de aaye hoye sade mehmanan ne sade naal gal baat kiti te sanu dassya ki eh jo tour kita janda is da maqsad hunda hai ki diversity da jehda message hai inclusiveness da eh spread kita jaye ਇਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਹ ਸਮਝਦੇ ਨੇ ਕਿ ਕਾਫੀ ਕਾਮਯਾਬ ਹੋ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਸਾਰੀਆਂ ਪ੍ਰੋਕਲੇਮੇਸ਼ਨਸ ਉਸ ਤੋਂ ਇਲਾਵਾ ਹਾਊਸ ਆਫ ਕਾਮਨਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਇਸ ਵਿਸ਼ੇ ਨੂੰ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਅੱਗੇ ਮੈਂਬਰ ਆਫ ਪਾਰਲੀਮੈਂਟਸ ਨੇ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਕੀਤੀ ਹੈ ਆਓ ਹੋਰ ਜਾਣਕਾਰੀ ਲੈਣੇ ਆਏ ਹੋਏ ਮਹਿਮਾਨਾਂ ਤੋਂ ਸੋ ਬਿਫੋਰ ਦ ਬ੍ਰੇਕ ਲਾਈਕ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਟਾਕਿੰਗ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਦੈਟ ਇਟਸ ਅ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਦਿਸ ਮੈਸੇਜ ਵਿਚ ਇਜ਼ ਬੀਂਗ ਸਪਰੈਡ ਇਜ਼ ਹੈਵਿੰਗ ਇਟਸ ਇਫੈਕਟ ਐਂਡ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲੀ ਇਨ ਦ ਮਾਈਂਡਸ ਆਫ ਦ ਯੰਗਸਟਰਸ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਦੈਟਸ ਦ ਰਾਈਟ ਟਾਈਮ ਵੈਨ ਯੰਗਸਟਰਸ ਨੀਡ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਟੋਲਡ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਡਾਇਵਰਸਿਟੀ So also, Rick, during the previous two occasions when you were a part of this tour, what were your observations when you were interacting, especially with the children and the way they were receptive, and also the elders also? So do you think that then when they listen to this message, they go home, they talk about it, and it further helps in understanding each other?
Yeah, that's the hope. I mean, it's one of the things we want to encourage them to do is the idea that they see the group of cyclists who have come together to do something like this. We represent a fair amount of diversity ourselves, and so the idea that we tell them how we've come to be friends and how we know each other and why we would care to do this together, and put a little bit of a challenge back out to them to when they leave to, you know, go and ask about somebody else, where they come from, what types of things they like to celebrate, and the type of food they eat, and maybe go try some other food, or try learning about a different language, or learn about a different practice, and,
right.
and have fun with that, and be learning that way. And so we often say, turn to each other, turn to the person beside you, and say hello and ask a little bit about that person.
Right, and also, is this message talked in your police department also? Because that is also very important with the demographics changing and diversity increasing every year. So how does these kind of events help the police force also?
So we just need to be the police department. I mean, we are a part of the city, a part of the community, and for us to be successful in terms of our role to help make a community safer all the time, we have to be connected to the community. And the idea that the police are the community and the community are the police is something that we think about. And
right.
so we want to make sure that we're reaching out in every way and that we're touching every member of the community and we're connected that way.
Mm-hmm.
We have other mechanisms we do that in terms of diversity. So we have some other purposeful organizations we belong to. We run a diversity advisory committee at our police department. And different people belong to things like the Human Rights Dignity Coalition, et cetera. So we're doing lots to make sure that we are connecting with everyone in the community.
Great.
Yes.
So Ken, if you could let us know the itinerary this year.
Sure.
So as you said, it's going to start from Victoria.
Yep.
So what time and further on the cities which you're covering this year?
Sure. We're starting on May 21st, which is World Day for Cultural Diversity throughout the world.
Okay.
So we're starting there, and then we'll end up in we're doing three schools in Victoria, then we'll end up in Delta,
okay.
Then Richmond, and then we're off to Richmond, then we're off to...
New Westminster?
Richmond, Vancouver, sorry.
Okay.
Burnaby, New Westminster, Surrey, and then we're off to Port Moody,
okay.
Coquitlam, Polco, Pitt Meadows,
okay.
and then Langley, Maple Ridge, Mission, Abbotsford.
Right. And the stops which you are taking, are they only in the schools or at some other places also where there'll be elders or some other intelligentsia from the communities?
Right. We're doing four universities this year, colleges.
Okay.
Royal Roads University, Douglas College, Kwantlen, and University of the Fraser Valley.
Right.
So, and also some other organizations as well. Yeah.
And how many participants have registered so far? And is there more scope also where if people want to just join for a short period, whereas if they cannot be in the whole movement, what you have started, but
right.
maybe if they just want to be in the city where they are?
We got about anywhere from 8 to 12 riders this year that are coming the whole way.
Right.
Then there'll be like the mayor or the city council or a few community representatives that are gonna be cycling throughout their town. So we'll have anywhere from 12 to 16 riders at any given time.
Mm-hmm. Now, again, the idea is to spread the message, as you said, of diversity. It's great we are saying that demographics are changing, a lot is being done, and things about diversity are being talked. But again, what we are finding still, you know, there's a hurdle which people in whatever community they belong to, they would prefer to come and just remain within their own, I would say, silos.
That's right.
So how do you think that further on, like events like yours and as well as the community, what role they can play to come out of this thinking and be a part of this inclusiveness?
Right. Well, it's creating that awareness is very important.
Right.
Once you create that awareness, change takes time.
Mm-hmm.
We don't expect change immediately.
Right.
But that awareness is something that we need to build. And we haven't done that very well, I would say, in the last decade or so.
Right.
But if we create that awareness, change will come.
Mm-hmm.
And that's important.
Right.
And that's what we're trying to do here. We can't change people how they live.
Right.
But we can certainly create that awareness. And how we move forward, and let people think, you know what, maybe I should reach out a bit more and invite people over to our homes and our neighborhoods or soccer fields. So diversity is important to our communities.
To our existence, I would say. Absolutely.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
We want to make sure that we celebrate to the fullest.
Right.
And that's what, Rick, he's been very kind enough to come out and support us right from day one. Actually, he doesn't say no to anything.
Oh, yeah.
You know, he's supportive, right?
So, yes, I do.
That's
and,
good.
You know, and you that's know, he, nice. You know, he's been fully recognized. Yeah.
And with his position, it does make a difference. People do appreciate all this. Yeah. So, like Mr. Rick, you were talking about the police part, what you have played. Yes. So, from the common man's perspective, what do you want from them? How can they play their role?
So just building on the earlier response there, I mean, it's normal to be part of your own community mm-hmm. for a good extent of the time, but we would want people to, and this would be more also at the adult level as well, is the idea that it is perfectly normal and healthy to want to be spending mm-hmm. time within your own community, but take a moment to think about the idea that you should be learning about other communities as well as part of diversity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, Harpreet, I think you were there that morning when we rode last year. One of the students raised his hand up. Sir, how long have you guys all known each other?
Right.
Well, you know, how do we answer that question? Absolutely. A lot of us just met the morning of the ride.
Absolutely.
So, and then we explained to the kids that actually half the team just met that morning.
Right.
So that's what diversity is all about. You don't always have to know each other to make a difference.
But relationships can develop anytime and anyhow they can just develop if you have that urge and if you want to do something about it.
That's right. You know, and Serena DiMartino Dirksen, mm-hmm. You know, I give a lot of credit to her mm-hmm. For being the backbone.
So that's what my question is, because it's a huge thing to plan, to coordinate. So who is the main person who is doing all this and this year? And as I asked you before also, if people want to be a part of this venture, how can they come to know, get more information?
Yeah, she's doing a lot of the organizing from the background point of view. We do it together. We collaborate a lot of ideas together. So mm-hmm. she's been doing a lot of the work. So I give her a lot of credit. Our website is www.cyclingfordiversity.ca.
Okay.
Where information is there. And mm-hmm. also our like page, Cycling, but it's different, it's FOR, mm-hmm. Diversity 2011. If you like that page, you'll be updated every hour during the ride.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Congratulations and best wishes. And this initiative which you started at a small level is growing day by day. May more and more people join this movement so that we are able to spread this message of inclusiveness. And though we should be proud of our own cultures, but also we should understand about others so that we make this place a better place.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.